The trade just got even tougher. A giant of modern Gaelic football. A living legend from the rugby fields of Wales. A Canadian icon of the ice. And the fearless general of the boys of Wexford. As part of the toughest campaign, GAA Club Championship sponsor AIB are sending professionals onto the battleground of local parish rivalry. And two GAA stars face the relentless grind of the world of the pros. Next week, the pride of the southeast, Lee Chin, has it all to do to find his feet with the Vancouver Canucks. And Canucks great Alex Auld pulls on Lee's jersey for the Fife Harriers. This week, former World Rugby Player of the Year Shane Williams joins Donegal champions Glenswilly, while the pride of Tyrconnell, Michael Murphy, is recruited by French rugby giants Clermont Auvergne. Four masters of their crafts, the ultimate sporting challenge. This is the toughest trade. Two Grand Slams, the all-time record try scorer for his country, World Player of the Year. But the challenge of Donegal senior club football is not lost on the Welsh wizard, Shane Williams.
I'm really going into this quite blind. I haven't seen a game. I've seen a little bit played on TV, usually when I'm in Ireland and I switch the telly on. Having played with the Irish boys, I know it's a huge sport. I haven't got a clue about the rules, but you know, I didn't know all the rules of rugby union, to be fair. I don't think anyone does, so it doesn't really matter, does it? You know, I was a rugby union player for some time, so I'm kind of hoping I can compete with these boys, and hopefully the body, even though it's a lot older now, can compete as well.
Before he heads for the hills of Donegal, Shane makes a pit stop in Belfast for an emergency crash course with an old teammate. Formerly of the Ospreys and Monaghan's Emmyvale GAA, it's Ulster and Ireland's Tommy Bow.
Tommy has a history of Gaelic football. I heard he was, well, from himself really, he said he was a pretty good footballer back in the day, and I hope he's a good coach because, like I say, I haven't got a clue when it comes to this sport. Tommy boy.
Shane.
Hi, Pa.
How are you, man? Good to see you.
How's it going?
Welcome back to Ravenhill again.
Good
it's
to be back.
It's been a while, isn't it?
You right?
It's changed a little bit since you were running rings around everybody here.
It's a bit posher, yeah. A bit posher.
How are things?
Good, good.
There you go.
Great.
Looking forward to giving this a go.
I tell you what, I need your help, pal. I have not got a clue what I'm doing.
I think the hardest part is, you know, he's used to getting the ball in his hands and just running with it. But unfortunately, he has to do a thing called solo the ball. Initially, I would say that's going to be the hardest part because he'll be so used to and he'll be excited to get the ball in his hands and to try and charge at goal and maybe go for a goal or a point.
And just flick it up into your hands.
Ah, right, okay, okay. Okay, okay. I think I'm not competition anymore for Tommy, am I? So he can give me all his tips and his tricks. But no, it was good. It was a short and sharp lesson. That's the best way I learn, really. Don't feed me too much information or I'll struggle.
Inside of the foot, yeah.
Oh, my God. Wow. It's quite weird, actually, in the inside of the foot.
Oh. Easy as that.
Hopefully now I'm a little bit more prepared. It'll be interesting tonight now when I train for the first time.
When you get the ball, don't worry about passing it. Just do what you do best. Just run about with it. And
I didn't pass much. When I
kick it over the bar and easy as that.
Right. No, thanks, buddy.
Top man, good to see you. Best of luck. Enjoy it.
Thanks,
I'm sure it'll be good crack.
Murphy wins the first ball.
He's led Glenswilly to three county titles and brought Donegal to the mountaintop. Having never played rugby in his life, Michael Murphy is about to face down the might of some of the best players in Europe.
Great shot, great goal!
I'm excited, really, to tell you the truth. The opportunity, I suppose, to train with a professional sporting outfit. We've been apprehensive, I suppose, about the technical side of things. Rugby is a hugely physical game. Probably try and avoid a couple of challenges rather than go head first into them. I think it'll be the best bit of advice, you know.
Michael arrives in central France to join the first team of the famous ASM Clermont Auvergne for a week.
Michael, I assume.
Neil, how are you?
How are you doing, mate?
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, welcome.
Thank you.
He is greeted at the players' entrance of the Marcel Michelin Stadium by team manager Neil McElroy.
Come on in.
That's great. Thanks, Michael. Thank you.
So when you come in tomorrow morning, all your kit's going to be in here. All right, so take your kit out here. And when you're leaving, goes in here for washing, OK? This is our boot room. This is where we keep all the dirty stuff and to dry the boots. Right, this is the changing room. So you're going to be in here, mate. It's a cheap seat next to the shower. But this is what we've got for you. So you can put your stuff in there and your shoes in there, OK?
I suppose you had some small ideas of what it possibly could be, but absolutely blown away really by the place.
And this is obviously the gym. Hey, big fella, how are you doing?
Right.
Here's Michael here from Ireland. You say hello.
Hello.
Sit up, Michael.
How are you? Nice to meet you. How are you?
Guys, Michael.
How are you? Nice to meet you. How are you?
Fresh in. Ah. Morgan.
Morgan. Recognize him. How are you?
Yeah.
Good.
Very good
stuff. Si tu vas taper dans la semaine, il voudrait bien peut-être mercredi et vendredi, non?
Yeah. Si je suis d'accord, s'il ne me bat pas.
He's happy for you to kick with him, maybe Wednesday or Friday, as long as you don't beat him. This is our cardio room. The idea of the building was to make it transparent, so if you're doing gym, if you're doing cardio work up here, you can see the guys in the gym, you can see onto the field. Restaurant, this is where we're gonna feed and water you. There's a nutritionist who puts together the menus for us and how it's cooked. Just follow the boys, we'll keep you right for the program. My office is in here. There's the boss, Frank.
Frank.
Michael.
Nice to meet you, Frank.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Yeah.
Looking good. Lovely place.
Yeah.
Great, lovely.
Is it similar to what you know?
But different from back home now.
And then the last room is the team meeting room. You know, we try and make sure our players have got everything, facilities, their kits washed, all that stuff. Look after the families, housing, cars and everything like that.
So your level of professionalism, what's laid on. Your player would come in the morning, he would breakfast, his gym, his medical, his kit, everything, just you name it, it's all laid on, it's all under one roof.
But there's a trade-off, you know, when they're on the field, no excuses.
A more modest setting in Donegal for Shane Williams as he prepares to take the place of Glenswilly's talisman.
Shane, you're very welcome to Glenswilly.
Thank you, good of you.
Listen, we're all countrymen up here, so you'll blend in well.
But I hope these aren't the players.
These are the players. That's the front row there.
All right, okay. Right,
here we kick! Go, Chris! Basically, turn out, don't get on the ball if it's not on! Avoid the contact! Off the laces! Her kick inside of the boot, inside of the boot. Ball start in the bank inside. Ball start in the bank inside. Let him know that shoulder.
For a man as when he played football this morning with Tommy Bowe, like, really, really good, really impressed.
Off the laces now. Support the play. Support it, Shane. Get off the pitch. Above your head. Catch it above your head. Go. Take a hop or a solo. Let it go. Get off the pitch. Go, Shane. Get off the pitch. Go. Attack them all! Stop waiting on it!
I hope this isn't just the warm-up.
Team 2, Randalls, Paddy Black, Shane Williams, Boyler, Cade Quinn.
I think we've got a game now, which is going to be even more interesting. I don't even know where I'm going to stand yet. So.
Shane, you're stuck in! Yellow ball, Shane, move the ball! Yo. Hold it, Ryan, hold it!
For a man of his age, 39 years of age, like, he adapted really well, he adapted really quick. He has that conditioning as well, I mean, he was able to stay with it.
Cover off the shoulder for him!
Massive room for improvement, but like, he has a lot of the basics, they're so good where they are at the moment.
Let's get in! Let's go!
Shane's week with Glenswilly will culminate in a challenge match with local rivals Convoy. And team trainer Gary McDade has some extra responsibility to heap on the new boy.
Shane on Thursday night now against Convoy, we'll put Shane on any scorable frees that are close to goals as well on Thursday night, I believe you. Kicked you, used to do a bit of kicking as well in the rugby, didn't you? So like you might even fancy it off the ground. We're delighted to have you for this week, and boys, give him a massive round of applause and welcome to the club.
Oh, it's great. I loved it. It's the first physical kind of training session I've done for probably over a year and a half now. It's a little bit different and a lot more to learn, but I've kind of got the concept of it now and I managed to learn a lot.
Michael begins his week of training with the first team, which will climax in a two-part challenge. He will have a place-kicking showdown with French international kicker Morgan Parra, and he'll play a full contact game with Clermont's second team, known as the Espoirs.
So far so good. He's trying hard, he's enthusiastic, he's trying to get used to the calls. I mean, it's not only a challenge for him by way of a different sports, a different language, different calls.
You know, today was non-contact. According to them all, it was a very light day. So the intensity was just average, you know. They were just able to go out on the pitch, focus a little bit on skills, and then just really, really focus upon themselves and the game plan. So that's all they do today. They were working through a lot of plays, and they want to do at the beginning of the week, they wanted to do them maybe at 50-60%. I would imagine tomorrow that'll ramp up. I suppose training every day allows them to do that. That's the one big difference you would see, you know.
He's done well in day one, but this is us starting to crank up the week again. This is our start-up day, following a pretty hard European match at the weekend. It will get tougher, so we're going to need him to be pushing hard.
The building blocks are there today, so it's a steep learning curve. As the physicality is introduced now over the next couple of days, that's going to be fun.
Deep in the Donegal countryside at the crack of dawn, Shane Williams has an early call for a morning workout.
It's 6 a.m. It's an early start today. The boys have got some strength and conditioning, and obviously I'm going to get involved.
Morning, how's things? Ready to rock?
Yeah. All
right. We had a tough session yesterday, but the bones and the body seem to have got through it okay.
Right, we'll jump in and just get a little warm-up done. 1 minute pick-up towards the end, just to get a little sweat up, and that's it.
And when the guy said yesterday they had strength and conditioning at 6 in the morning yesterday, I thought they were joking.
Right, smoother. I want you to up, catch and drop straight and stop straight down, straight down.
This is hard work after you've done this. You go again now.
So you good full hang, that's it. All right, 4, 1, good.
There's a lot of space and area to cover on the Gaelic football field anyway, and I didn't know that until last night either, so these guys have got to be fit.
Good.
When I started doing this with them, say, inter-county level, what you would have found is if you'd have gone to a club match in Donegal in 2011, you'd have spotted a county player a mile away. See now, they're not as well spotted because all the club sides are all doing the same stuff. So it's a case now of, you know, before if you did it, you had a head start, whereas now if you don't do it, you're behind.
Go! 1-0!
It was tough, it was tough.
All right, one more.
I just can't get over the lads, you know, getting up at 5:30 in the morning to do this, then going to work and then coming back for training later on.
As his old teammates head for work, Michael arrives at his new day job. His first task is breakfast prepared by the in-house chef and club nutritionist. Before he can get stuck in, Michael has to observe the club's morning tradition.
It's all here in Fanson and Claremont. That's the first thing in the morning. Everybody shakes hands with everybody. So, it's a bit strange to get used to. But something nice, definitely, that everybody kind of does it.
Bon appétit.
Yeah, it's good.
Fed and watered, now Michael will find out how he measures up to some of the strongest athletes in the world. it's time to shift some tin.
Michael is doing well. He's not like somebody that never done anything. So far, so good. Let's see how he does during the week.
Power seems to be the big thing out here. Some of the bigger lifts, like the pull-ups, when they were weighted, they were throwing on some serious kgs on it. Measurement tool that could measure your power output. Yeah, everything seems to be measured. For the set 2, 3, and 4, I was slowly but surely coming down, and they were able to actually maintain that power for all the sets. So that's something I think going forward I'll need to kind of keep going on.
The squat is maybe a bit under our people, but on hamstring is quite higher than us. He wanted to play with a professional rugby team. Maybe he have to improve his specific strength on squats, on power.
Donegal's Michael Murphy is 3 days into his week with Clermont Auvergne as part of AIB's The Toughest Trade. The pitch may be frozen, but today's the day the pros turn up the heat.
You know, coming in at breakfast, Nat, there's a little bit more seriousness in terms of the lads' heads. They're just making sure everything's right. You can sense there's a bit more kind of seriousness with this session.
Today we've turned the page and we're now in serious preparation for Bordeaux this weekend. So it's probably going to be the hardest session of the week. So guys need to get it right, so we need to make sure that a lot of the preparation for the game on Sunday is done today. So the stress levels are up a notch, and Michael's got to try and fit into that.
Not underestimate the challenge of these boys too. Absolute monsters of men, and they've been doing it all their careers and all their life. So for me, going from 0 to 100, going to be a big challenge.
We're numbers down. We've got 8 or 9 guys with the French team, a few injuries. So he's a useful addition to have. They put him on the wing, I think, because he's quick. I think it's an ideal position for him. He's holding his line anyway. He's doing the job that they give him. But he seems to be going okay. He's looking for work, and they're giving him some ball. They're not avoiding passing to him, which is maybe a good sign as well. He doesn't look like a fish out of water anyway, which I think is one of his biggest challenges. He wants to fit in, he wants to be like one of the boys. Yeah, we can't expect him to have all the technical attributes of a player that's been on the field for sometimes 10, 15 or 20 years.
A few tough days of training with Glenswilly have taken their toll on Shane Williams. And the ex-pro is about to discover that when it comes to recovery in the amateur game, you use whatever resources you have available.
I usually do pool recovery, but they've taken it to another extreme here today, and we're going to attempt to do a bit of ice baths in the sea. It's cheaper, and it's accessible and ready for us. We've had a tough couple of days training, and these two lads were just saying how they're going to go in first to see how cold it is. And if it's too cold, we're not going in, so thanks, guys. Let's go. It's January. Wouldn't advise this to anybody else, to be fair. Two of my pet hits, being cold and being wet. But I'll give it a go. I don't think we're going to be in there long, to be fair. It's looking pretty nippy. Boys are just telling me now it's a bit cold in there, so they want to come out, so I had to come out with them. So we'll just go and recover and have a good night tonight.
He's been fed by the on-site chef for the week, but Michael is keen to sample the traditional Clermont cuisine, introducing him to some fare that is not necessarily part of the nutritional plan. Is South Africa international, Flip van der Merwe.
So, chef.
Hello.
How are you?
How are you?
Michael, how are you?
Ah, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Well,
good little cozy spot.
You've been here before, yeah?
Yeah.
This is wonderful.
Enjoy. It's good meat, yeah. It's good meat. I hope you like a lot of meat.
I like the meat. Meat's good.
What color do you prefer? Red, rose, brown?
Red.
Rose is medium.
Medium. I got a steak the size of a plate there. It was kind of recommended by Flop there, so yeah, beautiful. Just real kind of real France. Some size of a steak there.
Yeah. This is the good stuff.
Yeah. On a Tuesday or Thursday evening back home, you'll be out in your training pitch playing. They have their training done during the day.
Can I catch you a piece of this duck?
So it's a luxury you have in your evening. It's probably something we don't have back at home.
You're France, nothing makes you fit.
Nothing makes you fit? So when you came here first, any French?
No France at all, mate.
It's difficult?
It's difficult. I must say the club helps you a lot in that matter, because you know everyone tries and helps you settle in, and they even have a guy that helps you find a house. Yeah, because that's another thing, is you think you just go look for a flat, but then everyone you speak to doesn't speak English.
With Flop, I got a very good insight as to what it's like to come over, obviously him being a South African. You can probably, I suppose, relate to the difficulty that some people would find coming over here. You know, they would see the bright lights of a professional contract and maybe the money that is here in France. The flip side of things is the language barrier, is the actual moving from away from home. And so you'd really have to really be thinking long and hard about those kind of things.
Shane has been named as the free taker for his final challenge game. On hand to help him deal with the pressure of place kicking is Donegal sharpshooter Paddy McBrearty.
You're the star, so you're taking the freeze.
Yeah, there's a lot of responsibility, a lot of pressure as well. Games could be won and lost on a free kick at the end there.
So usually it's just your two or three steps, whatever you do, you kick the ball with the inside of your boot.
Right.
So.
Paddy definitely makes it look easy, but it's great having someone of his calibre down here come and help me for an hour or so. He's one of the best in the business.
Oh! No pressure.
Might be a wee bit nerve-wracking for him, but he's played in big arenas around the world, so.
Oh my God!
Yeah, I don't see you getting to him.
Oh God!
That's a Gary Owen, as you'd say.
You'll be an end of that.
I think I'm trying to kick it too hard now. I'm catching it.
It was a lot better. Nice. Hold on.
I felt a bit better, actually. I think I've learnt a lot today now, and I actually had a few balls over the goal as well, which means I'm getting better.
You can kick the ball off the ground as well.
Do many players do that?
It's seen as a kind of a skill. Michael always kicks off the ground.
So. Oh, does he?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
right. So
he's a show-off as well?
He's a bit of a show-off, yeah.
Okay.
Good kick. Great kick.
On On a down day for the Clermont first team, Michael is finding out a little more about the club's history.
We are happy to have you. Thank you for coming.
The team was founded by the Michelin family, and today Frederick Henri Biabot, the former head of Michelin Motorsport, has a treat in store for their latest recruit.
I think that we have a surprise for you. They will let you drive the car on the track.
Careful, lot of power. Is it on here?
On, yeah.
Yes.
Fairly cool. They did mention that a few of the players do come up here from time to time. You can see how you can get a bit competitive. It's still a competitive environment, and yeah, when you get out there, brilliant out there today. Really enjoyed it, and knowing what, I suppose, the professional lifestyle and what it can entail and what it can bring. That's good fun. Thank you.
Sincerely, you are a good driver. It's very good.
Back in Donegal, Shane's covering the boss's shift in Michael Murphy Sports in Letterkenny, bringing him back to the last days of amateur rugby.
When I started playing rugby, I was a little bit later than the usual player. I was 20. Before that, I actually did work. I had a number of jobs, from working in a bakery to fitting windows to working in a job centre, so on. So I kind of did have that experience. Never have too many balls. Could be interesting. When you're a professional rugby player, they do this for you. So far, so good. I haven't broken nothing. Been here a good 10 minutes. Balls, balls, balls. Right, lads?
You've got to help this man find a pair of boots.
And a pair of boots?
Yeah, he's a bit clueless here.
No. What position were you talking?
Winger.
Winger?
Yeah.
You don't want them bad boys, then? Right, we need something light. Feel the weight of them. These are also very nice. Only €39. No?
No.
Not up your street?
No.
Why?
I don't like pink.
You don't like pink? Okay, fair enough. All right, well, we've got a white version. Do you want to try these?
Ten or eleven.
Okay. Oh my god. There's just millions of numbers here. Oh, hold on. What did he say? 10 or 11, didn't he? Okay. What's the team you guys play for?
Letterkenny.
It's Letterkenny itself, is it?
Just
don't know. Oh, nice. Yeah, you sure?
Yeah.
Great. Box him up, I'll take him to the till.
Cheers.
Okay, this is 55, all right? And the receipts in there, okay?
Yep. Good.
All the best to the rugby, buddy.
Cheers, thank you.
Like I say, they're really quick. Ta-da, boys.
With his final challenge looming, Michael takes advantage of some one-on-one pitch time with Clermont skills coach, Xavier Sadourny.
Yeah, push.
I just thought a rugby ball was simply put a bit of spin on it over a longer distance, but there was actually a lot more technical.
Arms, finish here, not. One more.
Oh. The players that you're watching on TV, it's just second nature to them, and they just do it so casually.
Ah, it's a bummer.
Specific skills coach is something that's enlightening in a way, you know, whereas maybe back home your coach has to cover all facets, from your fitness side of things to your tactical side of things, from your skill development.
And helping Shane bone up on his football skills is the first coach Michael ever had, his father Mick.
Good. No looping passes, boys. Who's looking for the ball off Shane?
Shane.
Well done, Shane, excellent catch. Just a wee bit of pace in it. We'll change the feet to see how we get on, okay?
Very fast, good learner, he has a good attitude. Obviously, there'll be days you'll have frustration, but you just have to keep at it. Michael was the same. He spent hours and hours practicing, and that's the only way you get good at something.
Ouais, speed. Keep the ball. Ouais. Aller devant et faire la passe derrière.
Every now and then, when you had a successful pass, you felt overwhelming delight. but that was in, I suppose, taken over by a thought of maybe somebody at 20 stone running towards you.
You want one more?
Yeah.
Allez. Speed.
It's going to be completely different tomorrow. I don't know what they have in store for me, but it's going to be a hell of a lot worse than stepping around a wee thin pole or a small mannequin.
Now we're getting it.
There's so many things going through my brain. I'm trying to think, right, okay.
But it's a new game, too.
Have I done four steps? Do I bounce it?
Yeah. Right. We'll get you there.
No, great.
We'll get you there, yeah. That's good, Shane. That's good.
It's a lot to take in, and it's the most tiring skill session I've ever done. They love to run you. It's very old school training, but that's probably what I need at the moment as well, having not done much of this.
That's all right, Shane. That's okay.
I want to really make sure I don't make a fool of myself on Thursday. I don't understand the game enough yet, and that's frustrating, but I've still got a couple of days.
Drive on, Shane. Well done. Well done.
In Donegal, it's the day before AIB's toughest trade challenge game, and Shane Williams is taking every opportunity to get used to the round ball.
Thank you.
Then it's on from Glenveigh National Park to Glenswilly National School for Shane, as he gets to see just how much his new team means to the parish.
Totally didn't expect that, to be fair. A little bit overwhelming, really. You could swear you were coming to Man United or something, and Michael Murphy's like a Rooney beer. They completely idolise him, and it was fantastic for the community. There's no homework tonight, OK?
And the school's most famous past pupil is heading to meet up with his French counterpart. The owner of H Park Sports Bar, his new teammate, Clermont legend Aurelien Rougerie.
How are you, mate? Welcome, bro.
Thank you.
Welcome in my restaurant, Sports.
Lovely place.
Yeah, lovely place. Synthetic grass, you know, for soccer. For football league, if you want. Rugby and
Mets, yeah. You've been with the Clermont club your whole life.
I played Clermont all my life. I was born here.
Yeah, born here. Yeah.
My parents come for the sports here. My mother played basketball for the national team, and my father played for Clermont and rugby, and voilà.
Quite a lot of similarities. You know, he grew up here, and you know, he started playing rugby at 6 years of age. He spent his whole entire career with the one club. I suppose that bears quite similarities to ourselves back home in terms of you play for where you're born.
2010 was the big highlight for you as Clermont player.
In 2010. I play. It's very. It's amazing.
You had lost four finals before that, was it? Four?
Four finals. My best. It's incredible.
I suppose the professional life is something, you know, that would turn the heads of many kind of Gaelic footballers or such, you know, for the opportunity to live your life as a professional. I suppose I did get an opportunity a number of years back in Australian rules to head over there to Australia to play. But my love for Donegal and just really, really wanting to play senior football for Donegal at the time was my only dream. And that really, really has kept me there at it. And I suppose the fact too that going away and living away and maybe even getting an opportunity to actually figure it out here this week, you know, being away from home.
Do you know Shane Williams?
Shane Williams,
yeah, the Welsh rugby player.
It's my nightmare.
Yeah,
you know why? Because he's a little one, small one, and with a lot of steps.
Yeah.
And it's a great player. And for me, I'm tall and big and slow. It's a very nightmare for me.
So he's over in my club at the moment.
Yeah.
So he's playing Gaelic football.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So that's at the trade. So we're swapping.
How does he? For the high ball, isn't it possible? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, we play the ball low to him. Low to him. So I would imagine he's going to be very quick.
Don't look catchy from Pearson and Oshin. Good, good.
And Shane needs to learn quickly too. It's his last session before his challenge match.
Huge improvement from Monday night, huge. Like, if you had him for another week or two, you could see a huge difference in him. You have to be fair to him too, that you have to build him into it and build up his confidence. And the more he gets on the ball, the better he's getting at it.
Go, Camper, I don't like him. Good, good, good.
Yeah, he's definitely getting there. Definitely getting there. Take on the keeper this time, okay? Come at the keeper. Oh, unlucky. Let's take him on. Keeper, come on, Shane, take on the keeper. Okay, let's go. Take a chin. Pop it over. Well done.
Now I think I've got grasp of the game far more, the more training I've done.
All right, that's support. Where's the support? Still there.
I still get nervous, and that's a good thing about sport. We may have a couple of hundred people there. You know, it's still a lot at stake.
Oh, unlucky.
A lot of pride at stake as well, because these lads won't want to lose.
There is just a day to go until Michael plays his first ever game of full contact rugby against the full-time players of Clermont Auvergne. So he's getting a tailored tutorial in the art of defence from forwards coach and incoming Ulster boss, John O'Gibbs.
Spine is in a nice side. Now, so find the medium of that. Find where you feel. Just even a couple of little things that we did there, it's about how you use your body more so than how much you can bench press. Now, is that a strong position or do you need to adjust?
There you go.
Okay, walk forward again. Yep, strong. Move forward. Good. Recruit. I think a guy like that that's got good body awareness, we just put it into a different plane or a different situation.
Okay, go. Run.
Good. Low.
Good. That's pretty rough now. That's certainly a masterclass.
Speed. Go. Good.
Certain things that are crazy that you don't think of when you're watching the game.
Don't forget about your chest. Okay, if you show me your chest, I can attack you. I'm 40 years old, going on 60, so I think this should be pretty easy for you. Okay? So don't let me take the ball off you. Okay? Ready? Go.
Stop myself from suffocating, never mind trying to get the ball released.
Roll. Perfect. Okay, good job.
Is that for it? Yeah. You know, he doesn't speak the language. You know, our guys could barely understand his English. But, you know, you can sense a competitor in the building. So, I think he's made a really good impression.
Good man.
Thanks.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, cheers. Thank you.
Time has come for Shane Williams. Tonight, he'll wear Michael Murphy's number 14 jersey for Donegal champions Glenswilly.
It's been a tough week, bumps and bruises along the way, but yeah, it's match day and they're ready to go. So, last thing to do now is just go out and try and play some Gaelic footy. Yeah, I still get nervous with whatever I do, really. You know, still got to go out there, still got to do a job, and more importantly, not let the guys down.
And as the boys of the Glen hit the field, the heavens open.
Ref. Get back! Drop! Cross the ball!
A foul out on the sideline. A difficult early chance for the novice free taker.
Good boy, Shane! Well done! I'm gonna score, Shane! Time! Shane! Back inside! Chris! Chris, take Shane with you! Good, Shane! Hold on! Joaquin, you're back! Joe, go! Chris, help him! Get out, Kevin! Keep going, Shane!
Midway through the half, Shane is starting to find his feet.
Oh boys, did he get tighter, boys? Sheehan!
What does it take to keep him?
Go cross! Go copper! Score! Score!
One of yous.
Go, Shane!
Good ball.
Great ball. There you go, Shane! Come on, Shane!
Oh! Good stuff, Shane.
As the first half draws to a close, scoring chances are thin on the ground, but management are pleased with the new recruit.
Incredible start for him. See what we did in training coming off here tonight, guy.
Look at Shane, look at Shane, look at Shane! Good. Unlucky, unlucky, unlucky!
A 1,000 miles from home, Glenswilly's favourite son prepares to take on an international place kicker in a best-of-three showdown. It's Para versus Murphy. A miss from Morgan Parra gives Michael a chance to go ahead. But he pulls his kick, and it remains all square.
Difficult. That's 1-1.
Il a fait un concours.
Two one.
Michael now has to land his most difficult kick yet to finish on level terms. Always deadly with a dead ball on the Gaelic field, Michael has just held his own alongside one of the best in the business. Shane Williams leads them out for the second half in the Donegal Blizzard. And from the off, he runs in under a high ball.
Oh, Shane, you're going to go there.
Oh, lucky Shane.
Look at Shane's way. Good opportunity. Oh, well done. Good. Good again. Good.
Look at Shane.
Look at Shane.
Shane's on. Give it to him.
Off him, Shane. Off him. Yes. Pick it up.
A good save, but it's still a point. A third for the rookie full forward.
There, another one. Good, Shane. Good lad. Good, Shane.
I didn't even have him for a month or two, you'd make some Gaelic player out of him. I got 3 points here.
Look, they weren't handed to him, like, you know what I mean? Good lad, Shane!
Good stuff, Shane.
Right. Yes!
Oh, yeah. Penalty!
If he converts this late free, Shane Williams will finish as top scorer in his first ever game of Gaelic football.
It's score, Shane!
In France, Michael's biggest test has arrived. A game of full contact rugby with the cream of Clermont's academy under the scrutiny of first team manager Neil McElroy.
Easily the biggest challenge. This is the real thing. At this level, we recruit nationally and internationally, so it's not just the best local guys. These are guys that we think could have a fully professional career. These are guys that we've handpicked to be the future Clermont professionals.
Go, go, go.
Get up, Michael. Get across, Michael, come on. Look for work. Get it, come on, Michael, your ball. This time. Getting the head in the right place isn't always easy, and he doesn't want him to be injured.
Early on, Michael's struggling to make an impact.
If you're carrying the ball and you're going to take a hit, try and take it on your terms, okay? Protect the ball and get your shoulder in.
And with that, the boy from Glenswilly starts to make his presence felt.
That's better. Dominated the contact and did a good offload pass after. That was good. Certainly the determination's there. Good man. Good carry. He's got pace and he's got strength. He hasn't rolled about. He hasn't been mourning. He's taken the hits and he's got back on his feet. So no, he's looking good. Yes. His movement's good. Good. Try, started by Michael Murphy. Minutes. Come on. Run, mate. Good. Well done. He looks as if he's keen for contact, which somebody coming to rugby from a different sport, it's not the most natural thing, you know. I think we might keep him. Is he under contract? No. Money talks, isn't it?
Yeah, I got dunked over a few times to begin with. Once that happened, I said I couldn't get much horse. So, yeah, I was delighted then to get a few runs in the game, you know.
One man is not here tonight, Michael Murphy. And he's held Shane in such high regard in this circle, so he is. And, like, it's a real honour for us to have someone like you come in and replace him for the weekend. So we're absolutely delighted and honoured to have you here. So well done.
I was going to just say something. You know, this week's been great. I've really enjoyed myself. You're a great bunch of lads. I fitted in straight away, despite the fact you take the piss out of me quite a lot. But I have no doubt you're going to have a good season, guys. You've got a good camaraderie. You're a good bunch of boys. And, you know, I'll come back and see you guys pretty soon and see how the season's going. I hope you don't play in weather like our week in, week out. So that was hard work, but no, it's been a pleasure. Thank you very much.
It's a great spot, but tougher than I expected. Didn't really know what I was doing at times, but managed to, you know, to get involved. We won the game, which is always a bonus. And the lads seemed to be happy with what I did out there most of the time, so. I still can't believe it's an amateur sport here. You know, they work their socks off for each other, and that's probably why these clubs are so successful. I've met some good boys as well, good bunch of lads, and it's just been a great experience. I certainly respect Gaelic football. Now I've played it and seen how fit these lads are. I think, to be honest, I've had the best swap. I've had a great week, and I've really enjoyed myself.
The captain's run before Clermont's top 14 clash with Bordeaux. And Michael Murphy's last morning with the team.
I think he have a great time. He run fast and he understand everything, so he can play rugby when he want. Huh? If you come in Clermont, why not?
certainly play a high level. You can see they are able to adapt all the time. And certainly that's why he is good. He understands quickly and he helps the team.
It's been really good having him around. It's been amazing how much he's picked it up. Hopefully he's enjoyed coming over here. It's been great having him here.
Delighted I did it, you know. Loved every single minute of it, to be quite honest. So you got a real grasp of what the professional lifestyle is in the middle of a season.
It's important to remind ourselves that you can still be a top-level sportsman and professional by way of your spirit and how you go about your work. I think that was an important message for us, and it reminded us that, you know, you can, as I say, be a professional without necessarily being paid to be professional.
Yeah, there's something lingering there that you would have loved to have done. You would have loved to have really been analysed the way these players have been analysed and just see where it would bring you. But you know what, you can do that at amateur level too, where I'm at. Don't get me wrong, I love the time here. It's a fantastic lifestyle, it's great, but I think I've made the right call. I'm happy where I am back home. That's where I see myself, and I see myself pushing myself forward there rather than anywhere else.